Another thing that we should pay attention to is to stand straight in the salam and make sure our rows are completely straight. And the Prophet ﷺ, he used to straighten the row just like a person straightens the arrow when he's about to fire. And he ﷺ, in some narrations, he would go with the sahaba and he would touch them on their shoulders and on their chest and on their back to straighten their row. Then, in one narration, it's mentioned in Sahihain when he believed that the sahaba all understood this. So he's about to see start his salah, and from the corner of his eye, he could see someone's chest sticking out. So the Prophet ﷺ, he turned around and he said, لَتُسَوَّنَّ صُفُوفَكُمْ Straighten your rows, أَوْ لَيُخَالِفَنَّ اللَّهُ بَيْنَ وُجُوهِكُمْ Or Allah Jalla wa'ala will cause differences to appear between your faces. And in another narration he said, or differences to appear between your hearts. And this is one great fa'idah that Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, he mentioned in Shah Mumtir. He says, there's a great fa'idah of Salatul Jama'ah, that Salatul Jama'ah unifies the ranks of the Muslims. And not only does it unify the ranks of the Muslims, it unifies their hearts and their faces. And forget about missing Salatul Jama'ah. Just not to be straight in Salatul Jama'ah will cause disunity to come into one's heart and it will show in their faces. So if a person leaves the Jama'ah completely, then it shows you how disunited the Ummah would be at that time. And this is why we find at times like this, the Ummah are so disunited. Because people are not bent in their rows. They are bent in their rows as well, but they do not come to the Jama'ah to even make a row. And this is why there is disunity in the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this is something that we try and emphasize on insha'Allah ta'ala. The ulama, they always mention regarding Salatul Jama'ah, a person should try his utmost. But obviously you are going to miss some, no one is perfect. Sometimes you oversleep, sometimes you miss something because you're outside somewhere. But try your best insha'Allah ta'ala to attend the Jama'ah. By this we conclude the dars insha'Allah ta'ala. Next question we'll take in the next lesson. So try and remember your questions, we'll take them at the beginning of the next lesson insha'Allah ta'ala, before we start the next lesson. And we hope to finish Kitab al-Salah. I think we've been two more lessons insha'Allah, Salah and Janaiz. And then we'll start Kitab al-Zakah. We ask Allah Jalla wa'ala to allow us to benefit from everything that we have learned, to make this a proof for us and not against us, and to allow us to reach the sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in every action that we do.